Upstairs, there's seats up there, but it's kind of cool, or would you rather bring seats down here where it's a little warmer? Which pleasure?
Okay, everybody ready?
Yes, here I go.
Okay. Today is March 4th, 2005. We are at the workplace of Mr. Vonderhorst on South Road in Marlboro. Today's interview crew is Alex Hunter on audio recorder, Emma Sharofkin on still camera, Kelly Forensic and Abadi Karen Smith on video camera, and Eli Fell as an interviewer. I'd like to ask you a few questions about your background.
Sure.
Have you always lived in Marlboro, or did you move here from somewhere else?
I moved here from someplace else.
Where did you move from?
I was born and raised in northern New Jersey. I first came to Vermont in 1955 and moved up here for good in 1961.
Why did you move to Marlboro?
I got married and my wife's family had a home here in Marlboro, on Salt Lake Road.
So how many years have you lived in town?
I think it figures out to about 43 years right now.
How would you describe yourself when you were a child?
Like to build things. My brother and I built a lot of stuff. We lived in the country in North Jersey. Did a lot of sports and just enjoyed the outdoors.
May I ask how old you are now?
I'm 69 years old.
How would you describe your carpentry business?
Well, when I first started, I did mostly remodeling, some new homes, general carpentry, did some masonry, and I think that's about it.
Have you had any other jobs than a builder?
Yes, I have.
What else have you done?
Well, for 6 years I ran a maintenance business, which was cleaning houses, washing windows, that type of thing, road shampooing. I also was a part-time law enforcement officer and did that for a couple of years, full-time. And I also had the privilege of teaching vocational education at the Marlboro Vocational Center for 5 years.
What caused you to stop, though?
Stop the jobs, you mean?
Yeah.
The different jobs? Well, the maintenance business I sold to my partner. Law enforcement, I enjoy doing part-time, but I did not enjoy doing it full-time. And at school teaching, the position I held was they stopped having it. I'm trying to think of the word, but anyhow, it was a school, so got rid of it. So,
how old were you when you first started working as a carpenter?
Well. started helping my dad when I was 8 years old. And my job was, my older brothers were helping with the building. My job, at that time we used boards, we didn't have plywood, and so each board needed, at each rafter, needed 3 nails. And my brothers would go along and get things on and put a nail in, and my brother Ted, who's a little bit older than I, we both had to fill in. We had to put, if they put one nail, we had to put the other 2 nails into the board. And that's where I first started doing carpentry.
Why did you start in the first place?
Well, just something I did. You know, my dad got me started and I followed through with it.
How did you learn how to be a builder?
Mostly by doing. I would say all by doing. I worked with my father until I was 23 years old, doing building and stuff. And just self-taught, man, I guess.
Did you work for other more experienced builders at the beginning?
My dad and I worked a little bit with some other carpenters.
From which builder do you feel you learned the most?
My dad.
What kind of building jobs have you done in your career?
Well, I've done barns. I did a big cow barn over here in Halifax. I think that's the biggest job I've ever done.
What are the ones that stand out in your memory?
Well, I did the Marlboro Town Office, which, the original building. I think that's probably one of the ones I enjoy most.
Are there types of jobs you prefer over others?
Well, I myself, I like remodeling. I also like some new, but I think remodeling is more the line I like.
Do you like building entire buildings inside and out, or just one or the other?
Well, if I do a building, I like to do the whole thing. My oldest son has now taken over the business, and we do 12 to 15 houses a year, building everything.
What are the parts of a construction job that you really like?
I like all aspects, because I'm just constantly doing the same thing every day. You get a variety of things to do.
Are there pipe parts you don't like, especially like?
Well, sheetrocking is one thing I don't like to do. So, but the rest is, you know, I like trim work probably better than anything. I think that's my preference.
Have you always been in charge of site preparation?
Yes.
What are some of the things you have to think about when planning for a building?
Well, you have to have things, get things coordinated. Basically, you before you even start a building, you don't know what you have to do, but then you have to coordinate, get the different people who are going to do the jobs, your people who are going to do the excavation, get them lined up. You contact your electricians and plumbers and sheetrockers, whoever you subcontract some work to, and you make sure that they're aware of what you're going to do and when that work is going to be available. Because that way, if you alert them beforehand, as your building progresses and when they're supposed to be there, they'll know approximately and have open time for you, so you're not slowed down doing your job. And that,
that's, I think, is a successful builder, is someone who can coordinate and keep things moving, keep his subcontractors moving.
Do you prefer to be the contractor and builder on the jobs you do?
Yes, oh yes, definitely.
What are the advantages and disadvantages of also being a contractor?
Well, some of the I think the one great disadvantage is the fact that you're relying on subcontractors a lot, and they're not always as accommodating as they could be. They may put you off a little bit, which throws your whole job off, and I think that's the major problem there.
Have you ever worked only as a contractor on a job and had a crew do the actual construction?
Well, we hire other contractors to come in and do certain aspects. When we really get busy, we've had to have a framing crew come in and put up the rough frame for us. And that would include, you know, putting up your framework, putting in the windows, the siding, and putting the roof on. And then we would pick up the job from there, doing the interior, getting the plumbing and electricity and sheetrocking, and all the things that go from there on to the finish.
Do you prefer to work on someone else's design, such as an architect or interior designer, or do you prefer to do the designing and building yourself?
Well, I've done both ways, and I think I would prefer to do my own because I have in my mind exactly what I want to do. Sometimes you find that things that have been designed for you or something you don't feel comfortable with doing in that particular way, and so you compromise your own thoughts and feelings a little bit.
Knowing how to do something and running a business can be two different things. How have you learned to do the other side, do the business side of your work?
Experience, just doing, and I don't recommend that to anybody. I wish I had had some business schooling or a little more business experience before I started, but unfortunately I didn't, so I had to learn the hard way. So.
What are some of the skills you need to have in order to run a construction business successfully?
Well, I mean, you have to have very good experience in building, but I think the biggest thing is coordination, because you have other contractors working for you. The ability to know, you know, with a particular building you're going to build, how much time it's going to take to do certain aspects, and to have, you know, your plumber, your electrician, and whatever.
What are some of the skills you need to have to keep a crew busy while on the job?
Good coordinating, knowing what you need when, just making sure that the fellow who is doing the cutting is moving fast enough to supply the rest of the men. Just kind of have a feeling as you're watching the job go and doing the job of what's needed, you know, looking ahead what's needed, and to have people have those items available for the job done when it should be done so that things can progress beyond that.
What are some of the things that can happen on a job that you can't plan but which have happened?
Somebody doesn't show up for work of your need, you know. Finding out that some key materials that you do need to keep the job going aren't there. You find out something's put in wrong, it isn't quite right, and you have to tear it out and redo it, and you have to do that before you can go on, so that slows down everyone. I think that's about it.
What are some of the situations that could make building a dangerous job?
Oh, a lot of things. You have to make sure when you're putting up your walls that stuff that is anchored in place. When you're lifting things overhead, you have to make sure that they're secure in place. Putting on roof trusses and rafters, you have to make sure that they're very well secured in place. I was in one job where that was not done, and we were putting up trusses. They weren't short correctly, and the whole, about 10 trusses came down. Luckily, nobody was hurt. So.
What people and experiences taught you the most about working as a builder?
Well, again, I would have to say my dad. He's the one that really helped me the greatest.
Your son has taken over most of the operations of your building business. Would you talk about the changeover from your point of view?
Yes, I would. It's my son, he started out as a paramedic. He was with Rescue in Brattleboro. Then he started on carpentry part-time. In a very short time, he became a good carpenter, and he is excellent at coordinating, a little bit better so than I am. And I think this is one of his strengths, and he has taken the business from one building crew, but we have two and three building crews now. And so he's really brought the business forward. He's helped it greatly.
What have been the easy parts and what have been the difficult parts?
Well, the easy parts are repetition. Like if you're putting on siding, you know, or something like that, it's the same thing. You're moving right along. Some of the harder parts is when you're doing trim work, is getting them fitted correctly stuff like that. Working up in high places a little bit harder. I think getting your trim work, your final work, and keeping it moving is probably your hardest.
What are some of the ways that the building industry has changed over your career?
Well, I think when I first started in this state, we used boards that were 6 inches wide, 10, 12, 14, 16 feet long, for the sheathing on the outside of the building, which takes a long time when you put on a single board. And today we use panels, which are 4 by 8 feet. And those panels go on a lot quicker. You can probably sheathe the building today in a day, whereas back when I first started, it would take you a couple of days, 3 days maybe, to sheet the whole building. Also, sheetrock in the inside of the building. When I first started, we used to use lath and plaster or wire mesh. And put one coat of plaster on, and then you would put your white finish coats on. This takes a lot of time. So sheetrock has very greatly enhanced the building trades today. I think those are the main things that really have pushed things forward.
If you were just starting your career today, would you want to go into building or would you choose some other kind of work? Why and what work would you choose today?
Well, I love to build things other than homes. I enjoy, I've no welding. That's one of the things I did in vocational education was a welding teacher. I love mechanical things. And I think if I had to do it again, I think I wouldn't mind become a mechanical engineer. And work on, I think, the invention side of things, of building new things, new tools. That's what I think is what I would do if I had it to do over again.
Did you do most of your work in the local region?
Yes.
How far have you had to travel to a work site?
Well, now I can tell you, I've traveled 5,000 miles. My daughter lives in Alaska, and I did a little, went up and built a deck for her this past summer. But realistically, we've worked in Keene, let's see, I've went up as far as up around that area, Alstead area, I did some work way back.
How do you get jobs? Is it word by mouth or do you advertise?
We mostly get our work word of mouth. We do very little advertising as far as the building. We also do for Sasasimo Industries, which is does a lot of home building area. We build all their homes, and we've probably done in the last 10 years, we've done a couple of hundred homes for them.
Would you talk about the recent job you had in town of building an addition on the firehouse?
Yep. That was somewhat of a challenging job. When we started digging for the foundation, the land behind the firehouse was fill land. We had hoped to get something to build on, not too far down, but we ended up going down at the very back of the building over 12 feet to reach hard ground. And then we had, from that point, we would put it into 4-inch increments, lay it out flat 4 inches and compact it. And from that 12 feet right up to the bottom of the foundation, we had to do that in order to get a base to put the building on so it didn't crack and fall in. So that was the biggest challenge here. And I think from here, once we got that done, things moved fairly along. And I did 70% of the work myself, just trying to keep things in perspective. And we were so busy, it was very hard to get, move guys over here, so.
Would you please describe a typical day at work from the time you get up until bedtime?
Well, when you get up, if you're a builder and running your own business, your phone will start ringing probably about 6 o'clock in the morning. And you have to talk to people about jobs. You call your men if you're going to move them around where you want them to be. So that starts your typical day. Between that and getting breakfast and your lunch, pretty hectic first thing in the morning. And riding to the job, it gives you a minute to contemplate what you're going to do and get things laid out in your mind, how you're going to run the job. From there, it's just things kind of fall into place. So.
What are some of the parts of your job you really like?
To see a job completed, I think, and completed right. And that's all down the line. The whole job is making sure that things are done when they should be, that you don't have to go back and redo them or find out when you've got walls closed up that somebody forgot to put in something behind it to screw something to. And I've always believed that if you're going to do a job, you do it right or don't do it at all.
Are there any parts that you dislike?
Is They say sheet rocking, I think, is the big thing. I didn't, don't like at all.
In your opinion, what are some of the difficulties that the building industry faces today?
Well, if you're a new house builder, it's finding land to build on is one of the bigger problems. Regulation, I think, is your biggest thing. But I think if the builder follows good building practices, that's no problem.
What do you see as the future of building in Marlboro?
Well, due to land scarcity, I think it's, you know, it's going, can only go so far and so fast. So it's a bedroom town of Brattleboro, which is going to keep it building somewhere. But I think the building rate in Marlboro will stay relatively low key and steady.
On a different topic, would you please tell us about your involvement with the founding of the Marlboro Historical Society?
Well, that was very interesting. I was a lister at the time in the town of Marlboro, and I was with a Lister Eames, who was born and raised here, and Hugh Whitney, who also was a Vermont native. And we were out listing, and Worcester was taking us, showing us some of the sites, historical sites that he knew of in town. And we all got talking, and we decided that something had to be done to get some of this recorded and some of this history down on paper. And we, that morning, went to see Jay Herrick, who was very instrumental in getting the Historical Society going, and we all talked about it that morning and decided that we would get a meeting set together and see if we couldn't get something going to get the Historical Society going. And that's just what happened. We got together and picked a date and had our first meeting. And that was the organizational meeting for the Historical Society.
Is there anything else about your life that you'd like to mention that I haven't asked you about?
Well, I've been very fortunate. I've been fortunate to be able to come to Vermont and live. I've enjoyed it. I've done many things here in town. I was a first job I had, I was a lister in town jobs, and then I got a, was on the school board. I was on the fire department. I helped build, I put up the first addition on the firehouse, which is what we're sitting in now. And watch Marlboro build, you know, moving slowly and watch things progress. I think Marlboro's a great town, and I'm glad to be a part of it. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, well, as long as you...